asking me how they can come to the UK even with an IELTS of less than 7. So many people are just stuck with IELTS. They are not able to make up with the minimum requirements. Some write a lot of times, and because of just one category, they find themselves not being able to meet the requirement. But in this video, I'm going to be showing you a new way, a way that you can actually become a UK nurse even with an IELTS of less than 7. So let's go. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, my name is Linda Eze. I'm a registered nurse and I work in the UK. So in this video today, I'm going to be showing how you can become a UK nurse even with an IELTS of less than 7. If you're already a nurse in your home country and you are practicing and you have a valid license, you can actually come to the UK and practice as a nurse. If you have all the requirements, that's fine. That is a verified document with Nursing and Midwifery Council in your country and the Nursing and Midwifery Council in the UK, and then you write the necessary exams and you pass, and you also prove that you can speak English, then it is very, very easy. I have a video where I listed out the process. I explained the process step by step. So if you already have all the requirements, or you don't need English, you don't need to prove that you are able to speak English, you come from an English speaking country, or you have been practicing in an English speaking country, then you have everything that you need. It's just for you to verify your documents and your license and everything, and you are good to go. And if you've not watched that video, go and watch it. That video exam is the IELTS, and in that IELTS, you need to make a minimum of 7 in speaking, 7 in reading, 7 in listening, and then 7 in writing. That's where some people find very, very difficult. Or you can also write occupational English test for nurses, and you have to make B's in speaking, listening, and reading, and also a C+ in writing. Now, if you are not able to, or you have written so many times, or you have spent a lot of money and you're still not able to meet this requirement, the good news is that there is also a way for you to come to the UK, because the nurses are really, really people are really, really in need of nurses in the UK. You have every chance to come to the UK in 2021 and beyond. So if this is your plan, struggling with the proof of English, what I have someone that just got a job through this way, so pay attention. So now what you can do is to come to the UK and become a healthcare assistant or a carer. There a way you can do this. Already you have to prove to them that you are a nurse. They also take midwives and other people that have experience in the healthcare. But now I'm talking about nurses. I'll make a separate video for others that are not nurses and want to be healthcare assistants and carers. I'll make a separate video for that, how can they can go about it. Now, if you're already a nurse and your problem is English, that's where this video is focusing. So the license, you also have to like put together a very good CV showing that you have been practicing, the skills that you have and everything, how long you have been practicing, a very good CV. And you also make sure you provide your nursing certificate. If you studied in university, your certificate. If you study in the School of Nursing, your certificates, your notification. You make sure that all those documents, you have them. And again, you also need IELTS, but it can be below 7. It can be below 7. So, but you make sure you get like 6.5 and above in all the categories, and none of them less than 5.5. Some agencies accept none less than 5.5. So you have a very good chance. Most times people make more than 5.5 in all the categories. The problem is getting 7 and above in all of them. So just write IELTS. I believe one IELTS will be able to make you eligible for this. And once you have this at hand, what you can do is you can do this in two ways. You can do this by yourself. I am an advocate of actually doing all this abroad stuff by yourself, but you can also do it with an agency. So to do this by yourself, you simply go to NHS website and look for healthcare assistant jobs and apply for them. Make sure you have a very good CV. At the end of the world, stay with me to the end of this video, because I'll be showing you a demo on how you can actually go about this. So once you have all your documents, head over to NHS website and look for jobs. Look for healthcare assistant job, and when you have applied to them, you tell them that you're already a nurse because you're looking to complete your you are looking to complete your NMC requirement, NMC UK requirement, but you're applying for health assistant job to enable you to get ready, and you are going to be able to fully register when you have all the eligibilities. And you can also tell them that what is holding you is the English requirement, that once you are able to do that, you can proceed and finish up with your nursing registration. So the second way to do this is using agencies. There are so many agencies that have cropped up now that you can actually use. So many of these agencies, they require experience. So when you have your documents, your nursing document, your license, and you have your certificates from your nursing schools or the university, and then you have your proof of English, you can just email them all those your documents, and they will help you to find employers and then help you to organize them, get ready for the interview, and assist you to get the job. But this one, we need you to give them a contract, like a contract fee. Most of them say that they will give it back to you when you get to the UK. So once you have paid the contract fee, they will assist you with all the necessary steps, and you find yourself finishing on time. Sometimes this may take long because they will want you to work in a specific location and at their own convenience. They will be communicating with you. But some people find it very, very helpful when the agencies are helping them. But you can also definitely do by yourself. What I can recommend is using both of them. You could use agencies, but if you don't have the fees, you can also do this by yourself. So when you are doing it by yourself and you're finding it difficult, you can decide to use agencies as well. There's no problem with using agencies. The only thing is that make sure that when you are using agencies, you have seen somebody that they have actually helped in the past. You have seen somebody that traveled with them. You don't want to walk blindly. You don't want to just like do everything because you want to get to the UK. You want to make sure you are doing this in the most appropriate way, so you will not have any problem. This is the end of this video. I'll be sharing the demo in the next video because this video is already long. So wait for that demo. I will post both of them almost at the same time. So watch out for that demo. I'll be showing you the job size to go, how your CV will need to look like so that you increase your chances. I will also try to find all these other agencies that are recruiting for nurses so that you will know the next step. You will not just watch this video and you go home confused again. You want to know exactly what. Watch out for that second part. I'm going to title it the same with this video, but I'll just say part B so that before I forget, I can also say that you can also come to the UK to practice as a nurse with a less IELTS of less than 7 by studying. You can decide if you have the money and resources and everything. You can decide to apply to a school of nursing here for a school program, and then during the process of studying, usually their postings are in the hospital. They have a lot of students. Usually in their program, their students are posted to the hospital. Through that, you can get more experience, and in your process of also completing your studies, you can continue to work on your requirements until you get them, and before you know that, you get a good job. So schooling is another option for you. If you have the right resources, just apply to schools. Most times the schools are going to take, they are not very rigid like the NMC that has a specific requirement. They will have their own English requirement, but sometimes some of those their English requirements usually is less than 7, or they will not require you to get all 7 in all the categories. So if you have the resources, simply register for a nursing course in the UK, and if you're already a nurse, go ahead and continue to work on your requirements until you get them. Students usually have like 20 hours per week to work and also make money, so you can actually make money while you are studying and at the same time trying to meet up with your NMC requirements. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.